Which team would you have, would you like to play for in the EPL?
Well,
scouts.
When I was young, I sent one video to Arsene Wenger. You know, when he was he was the coach for.
Hi, Arsene Wenger. I'm Michael Olunga Ogada. I'm a striker at Gor Mahia FC, which is in Kenya. I'm currently the best player in Kenya. I've scored 38 goals all season, and my dream is to play for Arsenal. I'm a young talent. I have 21 years of age. Potential signing for Arsenal, if nurtured. But I hope you'll consider my request to come there and maybe join also maybe your feeder team, if not the senior team. And in the next coming years, I'll be sure to repay your faith. Thanks for considering my option.
Did you listen to the Hot Breakfast this morning? Here's what you missed.
You joining us is none other
than
the Captain Mwenyewe.
What's him gone?
Harambe star.
Anajulikana kama nan.
Michael Olunga.
Oh,
by the way, he plays in Qatar, huh?
In Doha, Qatar.
In Doha, Qatar.
Yeah, man.
Or like Americans call it Qatar.
Qatar.
Oh, watu sijui ni nini bana.
Maarzao.
Mbaya.
Walapena kuzivuta.
So he's captain of the stars. And yes, the other day, they drew twice with Burundi and Ivory Coast in the World Cup qualifiers.
Mm-hmm.
So tuko hapo kwa...
Bado kuna hope.
Kuna hope, lakini wacha captain atuambie mwenyewe.
Your design. Welcome
to Hot 96, captain.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's good to see you, brother.
Good to see you too, pleasure's
online. You're a big man, man.
Your design.
Hey, mazee, 6'2". 6'2". Na meshona kushona.
Measures, ya mekula. Tunajua ni mtu wa kutoka kwa kwetu. Your design.
It's played with the likes of Messi and Ronaldo.
Ronaldo, mzee.
Hey. Ilianza lini, when did your career begin?
2013 is when sasa nilianza,
mm-hmm.
when I started
sasa
hiyo ni after nilimaliza high school.
Mm-hmm.
So 2012 pale Upper Hill, then yes. Tukaenda East Africa nini, I was MVP top scorer, then now Tusker wakanisign now straight from high school.
Uh-huh.
So hapo ndio nikaanza season yangu ya kwanza.
Yes.
Then nikacheza season ya pili Thika United.
Mm-hmm.
Then my third season nikaenda Gor Mahia.
Uh-huh.
So up what Gor Mahia Sandio breakthrough ilikam kabisa.
Uh-huh.
Nikakuwa sasa MVP wa league na nika pia breakthrough ya national team pia ikakam.
Okay.
So then after hapo now ndio nikaanza sa professional career vipoa nikaenda Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
So Sweden was my first stop venye nitoka Kenya.
Ulikuwa na caps ngapi za national team before?
Hiyo time ilikuwa niko na caps kama mbili ama tatu.
Yes.
Because I remember the game yenye ilifanya really really the Swedish people were impressed was Kenya versus Cape Verde.
Uh-huh.
We played at Nyayo Stadium.
Yes.
And that game I scored the only goal that won us the game.
Nice.
So then that time Cape Verde were ranked fourth in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So compared to us ilikuwa ni a very very big game. So great. Scouts were really impressed with how I managed to play that game.
Uh-huh.
Then wakasema sasa invite ikakam. Now when the season ended with Gor Mahia, that was around June.
Yes.
So when the season ended in December,
uh-huh.
then I flew straight to Doha. No, not to Doha, sorry, to Sweden.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, Stockholm. And then now that's how I started now my professional.
Uh-huh.
Pale Sweden, Chapa 1 year, Poa.
Ilikuwa top league. Sweden
ilikuwa top league.
Ilikuwa challenging.
Ilikuwa challenging sana. Cause
language, weather.
And then weather,
yes.
Because I went time ya winter.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really, really cold. Mm-hmm. For the first time, pia nikuwa natoka sasa out of the continent.
Yeah.
A new challenge, ukupale solo.
Mm-hmm.
So it took me really quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
To be honest, before ni adapt.
Yeah.
So ilikuwa like 6 months, sikuwa nimepiga bao.
Where?
So you can imagine coming from Kenya, nimepiga ka 40 goals all season.
Wow.
Then nimeenda Sweden.
Six months. Kavu.
Kavu, mzee. Sijapiga kitu. Sasa, but from there,
yeah.
Sasa, nika explode the latter part of the half. Nika uh-huh. have like 12 goals in 13 games.
Wow.
Yes. It was really an amazing start kwa sababu for African players,
yes.
most of the time wana hit ground vipoa the second or the third season because of adaptability.
Yes.
So for me, it was really quite impressive. And then that's how sa team yangu ikaniuza. From there, nikaenda China.
Ukauzwa?
Nikauzwa. Singeza baki.
Eh?
Niliingia.
So wali mekaganji na wewe?
Yeah, niliingia 5 year contract. Wakasema yes. Tuakuza after the 5th year. Lakini after the first year, niku already.
First year.
First year tari nishaua.
China.
Wakupeleka chinku.
Sa nikaenda chinku.
Yes.
So hapo ikakuwa ni poa, club wakaniuza record fee for their history of their club. Ikakuwa ni poa, nikaenda pale. China haikuwa fiti sana because by that time ndio walikuwa na ligi yao ilikuwa ina grow. So kulikuwa na a lot of issues na challenges na foreigners nini nini. So sikupata enough of time. So after like 6 months, then nika decide ku nikakuwa na interest from other teams in France, in Spain, wapi wapi. So then hapo ndio sasa nikaenda La Liga, sa Girona.
Kutoka China.
Kutoka China
straight
sasa
to La Liga.
Straight to La Liga.
Hey, bro.
So hapo pia ilikuwa ni one of amazing times zenye nili have, especially being the first Kenyan to score a goal in La Liga and also being the first Kenyan to score a hat-trick for Girona.
Wow.
And congratulations to them this season. They are going, they finished second, they are going to play Champions League for the first time.
Wali miss kidogo sana.
Kidogo tu. Waishinde. So congratulations also to them. Na hapo ndio ilikuwa ni also some of the best moments in my career. Nimesema having to play with the players wenye nimekuwa niki idolize, Messi, Cristiano, sharing with them the same pitch. For me, it felt really amazing. Unajua boy tu wa lucky uko amegrow tu ghetto. Na sahine za rub shoulders in the same pitch. Unajua? Like ili nipatia hiyo inspiration ya pia kuinspire watu wengine that it's really, really possible to come from ata Kenya, any part of the continent. Hapa Kenya, we have a lot of talent.
Yeah.
But with proper development and structures,
yeah,
tunaweza fika hizo levels zenye hawa wasio wamefika because they are just human like us.
Uh-huh.
And sasa from hapo ndio nikaenda Japan in 2018
summer. Umeuzwa sana bana. Umeuzwa sana.
Ndio hiyo. Ndio hiyo. Ndio hiyo. Unajua uzuri ya ball and then sisi kama ma striker, ni bao ndio inafanya kila kitu. So ukipiga bao, value inapanda.
Inapanda.
Wow. Absolutely. Yes. So each and every team right now in the world is looking for a goal scorer,
right,
a match winner.
Yes.
Eh, hapo ndio penye unasikia sasa hii Madrid inafuata Mbappe, inataka the best of the best kwa sababu kila team is looking for players who can decide the game. And luckily that is the talent that God gave me.
Your design.
So
nacheka na wavu mbaya.
Cheka na wavu.
Ukaenda Japan.
Ukaenda Japan. Yes. Japan ilikuwa ni really amazing, really felt at home. Was also one of the places where I really enjoyed most. Because their culture is quite different. The hospitality was really, really amazing. Na team ilini accept as one of their own. Unajua, going into the stadium, unafunga bao na wanakuimbia hakuna matata.
What?
Unajua, like they had a chant in Swahili.
Hakuna matata.
Just,
nani
just,
Japanese.
Nani Japanese. So for me, it was really, really amazing because that is where I felt nearly fly the Kenyan flag quite high. Na since the time I left kumekuwa na 3 other Kenyans wenye wameza kupata opportunity ya kucheza Japan just by the fact that iyo performance ilikuwa fiti. So yeah, then after 3 years in Japan nikakuwa top scorer 2 times, then nikakuwa most valuable player as well.
Wow.
I felt it was also time to leave now.
Yes.
Because now nikuwa nisha all the accolades nikuwa nimechukua.
Highlights zako kiwa Japan zilikuwa gani na gani in terms of performance?
In terms of performance, naweza sema nili set the record of the most goals scored in a single game in the history of Japan.
Ulipiga ngapi?
Piga bao 8 game one.
We mwenyewe?
Nane.
Piga bao 8. Hiyo game tulishinda 13-1.
What?
Ulifunga na kila part of the body. Kichwa,
mguu. Nilipiga kila part. Kila part.
Nine.
8 goals.
8 goals.
Wow.
Karibu hat-trick start.
Even hat-trick mbili na brace.
Na brace.
Sio?
Yes.
What?
So it, it was really amazing.
History of Japan.
History. So before it was 6 goals.
Yeah.
But then when I first half ilisha ni kuanisha piga 3.
Where?
So nikasema why not go for it?
Yes.
Then Ivo tu. And then the good thing it was the last game of the season. So pia kuna ile watu wame switch off already na nini na nini.
Yes.
But me I knew there was something I was chasing. So then ndio hiyo tukapiga hiyo 13.
Yes.
Then sasa from there my hat-tricks zimekuwa mingi, hizo ni countless. Nini. So for me it was really amazing. Hiyo ilikuwa ni one of the moments which nili appreciate sana. Na ikakuwa ni poa, and then now the the season ending ilikuwa ni poa cause nilitoka the year yenye nilikuwa MVP. The first African ever to become an MVP in the Champions
League. Ndio mwaka ulitoka.
Ndio mwaka sana nilitoka.
Vijana ya ghetto.
Michael Olunga.
Yes, I.
In where did you grow up again?
Lucky Sam. Ola jo Lucky Sam iko wapi?
Is there Lucky Winter? Is there Lucky? Kuna Lucky. Lucky ni ngapi?
Lucky ni moja tu. Na ni Sam.
Hey, Michael, what a story, man. You have, I hope you write a book one day. I hope Netflix does a movie.
Yes, I.
Because yours is a great story, man.
Yeah.
You have paved the way. See,
yeah.
Uma pave you in barabara for others because there's so many aspiring kids out there.
Yeah.
Young kids who want to be you, who want to be Messi, who want to be Cristiano. But, you know, the chances ni...
It's slim sana.
See, yo.
Yeah.
We need to have proper infrastructure. Yenye ina aid for good development for young talents.
Yeah. In our systems.
In our systems. Mm. So players can grow through the ranks. Unaweza tokata under 15, under 17, under Evo 23. Mm. And then you climb to the national team. So for me, nasema, we need to invest more on infrastructure. And infrastructure is good pitches, good academies, good scouting network. The reason why I say so, it's because East Africa for the longest time haijakuwa football giants in the global market.
Mm.
So most of the scouts, they prefer to do their scouting in West Africa.
Yeah.
Because they are producing many players when you wanna enter Europe.
Mm-hmm.
So for us kufika level yenye scouts are now
interested.
Yeah.
We need first of all to have good infrastructure and exposure in terms of we need to televise majority of our games, if not all, because by the time as we are leaving, we had SuperSport was here in Kenya,
yeah.
And it really did a good job in terms of marketing of the players. Players could have their highlights. Ungeza kuambia scouts uko kuna game tunacheza leo 3 p.m. ebu watch.
Mm-hmm.
Then kunaweza kuwa na hiyo feedback yenye anaweza kukupatia.
Mm-hmm.
So first of all, ninge champion for all the games zikuwe televised,
yeah.
Because why I say so, kuna talents hata kwa teams zenye si Gor Mahia, FC Leopards,
mm-hmm.
Uko nationwide, kuna a lot of talent, but we need easy talents in itaji exposure. So exposure, and then now from there, they can be identified, and then now they can be put in a system where wanafuatiliwa in terms of training, in terms of diet, in terms of coaching. Because mm-hmm. football is not only about the talent. Kuna other aspects of the game, which also need to go hand in hand, so that unaweza kuwa a complete package player, yeah. Yenye it is ready for out there to go and compete.
Amazing sana, mm-hmm. Yeah, kwa sababu unacheki challenge kubwa na kuwa galazima ushine Harambee Stars.
Right.
Let's say you want to recommend a player. They ask you the first question, is the player playing for the national team?
Mm-hmm.
Because they believe that if you are the best, you need to be in the national team.
Yeah.
But sometimes that narrative is not true.
It isn't.
There are other players who don't make the cut, but they are equally
good
as well.
Mm-hmm.
So by us in improving or expanding the scope where we can widen the scope where we can see players and we can recruit players, then it will make it much more easier, and it will open also another channel that not only that you have to be in Harambee Stars,
yeah,
for you to go out there and make it.
Do you think mapero wenye wanaweza skiza weju umeenda majuu unayafuata
kabisa kabisa? I'm with you.
Okay, weju umeenda mayolo, watu hii wakaweza tafutiwa education opportunities abroad.
Mm-hmm.
Like for instance, there's a couple in Barcelona right now.
Yeah.
Umeona Kibet?
Nimeona.
Ameenda?
Kuna
mwingine anaitwa Amos
Wanjala.
Uh-huh. You see, there's opportunities, right?
Yeah.
But there's few and far between.
Uh-huh.
Now, where will they end up? Wawili.
Uh-huh.
Unaona?
Yeah.
So, masomo inezika fungua, inezika widen the scope, labda tukienda universities za ngambo, ama high school za ngambo, ama even primary school za ngambo. Awa toi kutoka uko, is it a bit easier wakisomea uko in terms of kutroi kuwa expose kwa hizo opportunities za maju?
Uko inje kuna much more exposure. Because aim yako ni ucheze hapa Kenya, utoke na uende ufike, let's say, Spain,
mm-hmm.
England. But if you can go to England at an early age,
yeah,
why not do it? You shorten the route.
Yeah.
Unaelewa?
Yeah.
So for me, first of all, kwanza, ningependa kushukuru parents wote wenye sahi wako open-minded. It's not like before time yetu it was a little bit difficult because parents walikuwa me strictly on education and education. Ilikuwa ni very like football kitambo watu maybe wako wanaiona ni kama it's a career ama kitu yenye inaweza kukupatia do or anything inaweza make your life a much more better person. So first of all, mimi ningependa ku thank all the parents wenye they are really open minded and they are really supporting their kids through anything, be it soccer, art, sana. Because sahi sana imekam in such a way that it can be a career and it can really really change people's life. So inaweza saidia of course kukuwa na shule zenye zina appreciate talent na shule zenye zina fanya a lot of partnership, because when you mention the two players they were just here in St. Anthony's Kitale last year. But kuna hiyo now program yenye exchange program which they are doing, so pia ningependa ku urge more schools to also partner unajua wakuwe na hizi ma exchange programs because also now then it makes it much more easier for now the scouts to come in grassroots which is the school. So venye niko nasema huu mchezaji si lazima kuje Kenya Premier League au alitoka straight na wasahi wako Nastic in Spain. So in the next 2-3 years tutakuwa tunaona, and they really did a good job with the under 18 Kenya team. So those are the kind of opportunities pia tungependa the schools pia waweze kusaidia in terms of exposing the talents.
Yeah, the other thing is, speaking of exposing and being out there in Mayolo, as you call it.
Mayolo.
Racism, Michael. Racism out there. I mean, you were in Sweden, you were in La Liga, you were in Japan, you were in China, and now Doha. There's got to be, you know, is it as bad as we hear?
Well, I can say there is racism here. Some are bad, some are not bad. For me, I can only say I've encountered it in Spain when I was in Girona. I think there was a game which we lost.
Yeah.
Na ikakuwa ni noma sana huko ma tweet nini monkey nini.
Wana kuita. Na wajali openly.
Na wende wapigia hat-trick ya kwanza in their history. And then when you lose, wanaanza kukuangushia matusi.
So ni kitu ina happen. And especially unajua sisi tukienda huko tunaenda kama foreigners. It's like we are going to take what is theirs.
Yeah.
So nobody anaweza kuwa pia happy na you coming to take what is their in their motherland. So you really have to be strong mentally. And that's why nasema sometimes people only look at the good side of football, which is maybe scoring goals and making money and stuff. But there's another big aspect yenye inachangia sana for you to become also a successful pro athlete player. You really have to have a strong mental capacity where you can bounce back. Why I say so, kichukua just a recent example, juzi tukicheza na Burundi. The game was disappointing. Yes, we took a draw, but it was disappointing. But in 3 days, we are going to play African champions. You need to really bounce back as soon as possible and watch your frustration. So why I'm saying so, because now utapata hizo maybe racist chants or utapata those kind of comments, but in 3 days you are going to play Real Madrid or Barcelona. You cannot keep on living on
in the past.
So mentally lazima you bounce back, but then it's sometimes it's subtle in a way that you don't see it, but
Ego.
Especially us as black as black players, when you tunacheza huko nje, we really have to be stand out na lazima tukue out there. But na thank pia also the federations wamejaribu as much as possible to fight your vice. Na wame stand up pia with the black players, with the movements zenye black players wame initiate and everything. So imesaidia sana to change the game and also how black athletes wanakuwa viewed outside there.
Tell me something, how come there are not many Kenyans in the EPL? You know, since Wanyama, Origi's not quite Kenyan, lakini, you know, kidogo, kidogo. First of all, which team would you like to play for in the EPL?
Well, when I was young, I sent one video to Arsene Wenger, you know, when he was the coach for Arsenal. If you Google somewhere kwa YouTube utaipata. That time I was Kenya, ndio likuwa natoka sasa Kenya, nikamwambia nini nataka nikuje Arsenal. But of course it's the dream of each and every player kufika EPL. And unajua, congrats to our pioneers, Mr. Victor Wanyama, kwa pale first Kenya, unajua kupiga. But kuna a lot of restrictions pia zenye zinafanya pia players hatuwezi fika hapo. Because you first of all, our federation, we have to be top 75 in the world to make it the cut. First site ko I think 108 or something. I don't remember the last time we fika hiyo 70.
Yeah.
So first of all, hiyo ni a barrier yenye iko hapo, and that is now where the national team progression comes in. And then issues za visa and everything, kupata work permit, you know. So there are some background information which zina restrict players, and it's much more easier for players maybe to advance to leagues like Spain, Germany, France. But in England, specifically England, kuna restriction, and I even remember there was a time McDonald Mariga was just about to make a move to Manchester City. Remember, even by that time, the former Prime Minister, Honorable Raila Odinga, he tried even to intervene to Man City, but it was really, really quite impossible, because they have rules and regulations that govern how players enter the EPL so that they can keep it very, very competitive. So it's not impossible. It's not impossible to go to England, but of course the route for the Kenyan players is quite long.
Shame, huh? Because the talent is there.
The talent is there.
Kumbe ungekuwa Arsenal is
Baya za. Venga alikureplya.
I could reply. Because imagine how many people
wamemtumia.
And then also how these clubs work is not the same way we think. They have scouts.
Yeah.
They have a board of committee to study the kind of players that they want, because each and every coach akona player mwenye ana fit kwa system yake.
Right.
So you really have to also go and prove it out there in Europe, so that waone pia, okay, now you're a good player, you can go and compete with okay, let's say players in Sweden. Then in Sweden you progress, you can go to Belgium, or you can go to Italy or anything, and then from there now you progress to the next level.
Amazing. Mascout manze, kuna watu wangependa sana link ups yani, kama uko na uwezo wa ku link up mapero na watu wao kwa mascout wa majuu, inaweza kuwa amazing sana. Hiyo tutaitake offline.
By the way, you are the only Kenyan in the Doha League.
Yes.
The only.
Yes.
Hey manzi.
No mare.
Mbaya.
Na unapanga kuipiga. Saizi umepiga miaka ngapi? Tangu 2020?
Tangu 2020 sahi.
Doha.
So hapo ndio sahi tunasukuma.
Na una plan kuipiga mpaka lini?
Tutapiga tu as long as tunapiga hizi mabao.
Yes,
tunajua always uko kwa soko. So hapo iko tu sawa. Tunashukuru pia, and then kuna amazing support ya Wakenya pale.
Sana ni wengi.
Sana ni wengi. So wako over 50,000.
Future plans. In terms of after umemalizana na futa, unapangaje mzee?
Of course, vitu ni mingi. Tuangalia tu sasa nini itakuwa ni much more, itakuwa inaweza ku come through. Of course itakuwa ni first ku take time kidogo, pia unajua after umecheza now you need just to enjoy pia kidogo kazi yake. But of course pia now sasa itakuwa sana kurana another aspect of the game, which is now commercializing the game, because for the longest time venye nilikuwa nakwambia watu wako wanajua futa or any other art inaweza kuwa career.
Yeah.
So ni ku bring another aspect of the game,
yeah,
which is now commercializing the game much more, so that the little game yenye tunacheza, there's a way you can reap from it.
Yeah.
So that isikuwe unajua venye umesema kuna athletes wengine wenye they take and spend time with football, and then in the long run umetoka hapo
unakuja kuwa mtangazaji,
hujapata anything
au umesota
so inafai kuwe ni at the end of the day at least kila mchezaji anakuwa appreciated,
anapata kitu, anaput food on the table.
Exactly. Your so design.